Now to News Nation's Border Report. We have new stunning video out of the Rio Grande Valley where troopers chased a car filled with 15 migrants. 15. They had to use thermal imaging cameras to track them down. All of this comes as migrant encounters at the U.S.-Mexico border exceeded more than 250,000 for the first time ever. Some of those caught part of the terror watch list. Correspondent Robert Sherman is live for us in San Diego with a closer look at these record-breaking numbers. Robert.
And Marky, the numbers speak for themselves. More people attempted to cross the U.S.-Mexico border in December than ever before. Some of those people have been flagged as potential threats to the U.S.
December was a month unlike any other at the U.S.-Mexico border. In a Friday evening drop, U.S. Customs and Border Protection released its latest report, showing more than 250,000 migrant encounters, an all-time high.
So there's over 300,000 nationally. We're seeing increases in areas like Florida, the coast, even the Canadian border.
Ronnie Scott, former Border Patrol chief, says the numbers have him extremely concerned, especially since it's once again on pace to be a record year. But another number that's set to break records is the number of people on the terror watch list encountered at the U.S.-Mexico border.
This is a significant threat to the United States, and we're ignoring the fact there are real national security threats mixed in with this mass migration.
In the past 3 months, there have been 38. Last year as a whole, there were nearly 100, a sharp increase compared to the previous 4 years. It's estimated the terror watch list has nearly 2 million names on it of people who represent a potential threat to the U.S. But that's not all border agents are seeing. In the last 3 months, 146 gang members have been encountered at the border, more than a third affiliated with MS-13. The Border Patrol chief of the Del Rio sector taking to Twitter to report his agents have apprehended 38 sex offenders since October, many of them convicted of crimes against children. That's why human smuggling is so common. Some come from across the globe and pay extra to be snuck into the U.S., like this chase in the Rio Grande Valley, where 15 migrants bailed out of a car in a field and took off running. Thermal imaging was required to track them down. Jonathan Lines, Yuma County supervisor, believes deterrence is the first step.
We've got to address, you know, the deeper root of the issues and the appearance or the lack of willingness of this administration to actually surge at the border, shut it down, and deny illegal entry is something that needs to be addressed.
Right now, everybody who we're speaking with in law enforcement is telling us that at this point, the cartels are simply in control of the border. And in order to regain control of the situation, they say you have to retake control of the border. Marky?
Just remarkable coverage. Robert Sherman, thank you so much, as always.
Thank you for watching. Go to NewsNationNow.com to find NewsNation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.